So, as I said, today we are praying against the spirit of hatred and hostility. The spirit of hatred and hostility is a very serious demon. Let me use the word demon, because the spirit of hatred, the spirit of hostility is demon, and this demon is from devil. So, hatred, hostility, if you like, when we say love is the essence of God, and then the opposite of love is hatred, that means hatred is the essence of devil. If we say God is love, on the other hand, we can as well say devil is hatred. When we say love is the essence of our faith, we can as well say hatred is the essence of darkness, the kingdom of darkness. Hatred is the essence of the kingdom of darkness. You must hate for you to be a child of devil. You must be hostile for you to be an agent of darkness. You must be hostile for you to be a channel of darkness. So, hatred, as we know, can lead to death, killing. And as simple as the term metal, hatred, hatred is the cause of hostility. Hatred is the cause of jealousy. Hatred is the cause of household enmity. Hatred is the cause of division. Hatred is the cause of poverty. Because when you hate someone, even if you are in a position to help that person, you will not help. Hatred, it has caused a lot of havoc in so many homes. Even in our society, hatred. People are tribalistic because of hatred. People are becoming so hostile to each other because of hatred. Hatred leads to war. One tribe hating another tribe is enough to cause war. I hate the Hausas. I hate the Cameroonians. I hate the Africans. I hate the Americans. I hate the Australians. I hate the Asians. I hate the Muslims. These are warfare languages. If you are not careful, it is enough to trigger war. Because you will not want to use eyes to see the people you hate. And you can do everything possible to eliminate people you hate. So that's why hatred is a serious problem, especially in the family. And this hatred, all the hatred you find in our world today, all this hostility you find in our world today, started from the family. A family that is built on love has no business with hatred. Whereas a family where you find hatred, those children will grow up without love. Those children will grow up to oppose love because they did not experience love in their family. And so they can hate, they can kidnap, they can even traffic their fellow human being because of hatred. So when the Bible says, train up a child in the way he should grow, and when that child grow, he will never depart from it. Proverbs 22 verses. Train up a child in the way of love. If you train your child in the way of love, that child will grow to be a loving being. When you train a child in the path of love, that child will continue to walk in the path of love. But when you train a child in the path of hatred, be rest assured that that child will produce nothing but hatred. When you train a child in the path of hatred, be rest assured that that child will grow up to become an agent of hatred. When you train a child in the path of hatred, be rest assured that that child will grow up to become a channel of hatred. And that's why our world is in a mess today, because there are so much hatred, so much hostility, so much animosity in our world today. Christians hate the Muslims. Muslims hate the Christians. They hate you. They hate the Christians. Brahma Kumaris, they hate the Christians. Just like that, hatred all over the place. Protestants, even among the Christians, there is hatred. Eh? The Pentecostals will never want to use eyes to see the Orthodox Church. Neither the Orthodox Church wants to use eyes to see the Pentecostal. Hatred. When a Pentecostal is in office, he will want to employ his fellow Pentecostals. When a Catholic is in office, he wants to employ a fellow Catholic. When the Orthodox Anglicans, they are in the same office, they want to employ an Anglican. Why? Because they hate people from other religion or denomination. Hatred is the problem. Hatred is the root of all the problem we have in our society. And all this hatred, all this problem starts from the family. The family is the nursery ground where hatred is planted. Show a child love, and that child will grow up to become loving. Train a child in a hostile way, that child will grow up to become hostile. And unfortunately, all the channel through which we are training our children today, they are hostile. We expose our children to all forms of hatred. Look at what we give them to watch. For instance, when children are watching wrestling, hatred. Look at the passion. Look at the hatred. Look at the passion. Look at the hatred. When you are watching wrestling, you see hatred in action. You see aggression in action. You see hostility in action. You see people fighting because of their hatred against their opponent. And we don't see anything wrong with that. Our children realize we expose them to violence, we expose them to hatred. It's part of their training. In fact, any home where you don't have wrestling, any home where you don't have horror films, you know, it's like those students, they will sneak out and go and watch it in the neighbor's house. Horror films where you find hatred, war. Children love violence from home. All these things are from home. You keep you know, feeding them with violence. You know, you keep feeding them with hateful speech, hateful violence. Look at what is going on in Nigeria now. Yeah? In the name of republic, you want to gain republic at all costs. And then you have that passion, hatred for other tribe. You just, anything you open your mouth to say, they are hateful speech. You just hate every other tribe. The only tribe that matters, the only tribe that values is your own tribe. Other tribe, you hate them with passion. And you are ready to kill, you are ready to fight, you are ready to destroy. Hatred, look at the passion with which you people talk about other tribes. And people see nothing wrong with that. And you call yourself a Christian. You are a demon. You call yourself a Christian. Eh? You are agent of devil. Because that hatred you are propagating will still bounce back to you. When you hate people, whatever you throw out, that is what will come back to you. You hate other tribe. Other tribe will definitely hate you. You know, where there is no love, plant love, and you will harvest love. The same way, where there is no hatred, when you plant hatred, you will reap the seed of hatred. Don't think you are the only one that will hate other tribe. The moment other tribes discover that you hate them, definitely they will hate you. Hatred. Any seed you sow in this world, that is what you get. If you sow the seed of hatred, hostility, you will surely reap the seed of hatred and hostility. If you sow the seed of love, you will get the seed, harvest of love. Why are you sowing the seed of hatred? Why are even some of these children that are innocent children, you have brainwashed them. You have made them to see other tribes as enemy. You have made them to grow. How you parents pity your children? What type of generation are we going to have? What type of future are we building? Future that is full of hatred? Future that is full of hostility? Eh? Look at what is happening between America and China. Hatred. When you listen the way the Americans talk about Chinese, hate, full of hatred, passion, hatred, deep hatred. Eh? Where are we going with all this? Hatred. Look at what is happening now. Hey, black man life matters. And in the process, you are projecting hatred against the white. Black man life. Whose life doesn't matter? And yes, a black man's life matter. Remember that white man's life also matters. Hatred. Where is this hatred leading you to? So much hatred. Either because of race, because of color, because of tribe. Hatred is hatred no matter where you find it. And hatred has destroyed our world. There is no more love. Why people, look at when the Chinese were suffering from COVID-19, the whole world we are literally laughing at them. The whole world we are literally celebrating them. Eh? Some even call it Chinese virus. Eh? Because of hatred. Don't worry, it will not get to us. That virus is Chinese virus. And then they started closing their border. Because of hatred. Let them die. Let them die. Let them die with their virus. Let them die with their virus. The moment they close their virus, their border, hey, God now show them that virus does not know any border. It can travel. And then the border they close did not even stop the virus from entering their country. Hatred. This would have been a time the world would have rallied around. I thought there is something they call UN, General Assembly. That is the time they would have rallied around. Fight a common enemy. Fight a common enemy. Instead of them to come together to fight a common enemy. Hatred, that hatred made them to be closing their border, discriminating against one another. The level of hatred, discrimination you find during this period of COVID-19, in fact, in the history of humanity, we have never experienced it before. And it's because of that discrimination, that hatred, that the virus thrives. The virus thrives. Hatred. Whereas if the world has come together in love, join hands together, help. Let's use the word help. Because when one part of the body is sick, the entire body should be sick. So, but they did not see it like that. Hatred for Chinese was the cause of this spread of coronavirus. Because the world did not take it for granted. They just say, after all, it's Chinese virus. And they were busy protecting themselves. They were busy building their own borders. Look at it now. How many deaths have we recorded in the United States of America? Hatred has caused us a lot. It is this same hatred that we have in, political parties. You will see families divided in the number of political parties. See what is happening in Nigeria now? Hatred. I listened to some of this stupid, irrational campaign. I said, let me see whether I can get one value. Let me see whether I can get one reasonable thing these people will say. Instead of them to come out and tell you what they will do for their society, this one will come out, hey, we will criticize the other party, run down the other party. Hey, the snake have left our party. Now and the other one will come up and say, hey, now that I have this camp, these are the same people, the camp on, just for their selfish interest, you know? Any little thing, you jump, you are butterfly, you jump to the other party. No principle at all. Nothing. The same people that will use their mouth to condemn one particular party. Tomorrow, they will still join that party they use their mouth to condemn. Hatred! You don't know that in the future, you will still join them. Hey! A party you use your mouth to run, you gather all their umbrella, you set it ablaze. Hey, I have renounced anything that has to do with PDP. But tomorrow something will happen. The same party you have renounced, hated, you will still go back to it. Oh my God. Eh? You gather people's broom. Gather broom. I am burning this party. Everything that has to do with party, I have burned it. I reject it. You set it ablaze. And tomorrow, for your own selfish interest, you will still go back to the party you have burnt their logo. Hatred. And how they do it, I don't know. I can't understand. With the same mouth, they curse, they renounce. So tomorrow now, after condemning your country, condemning your party, you will still go back to the party. You will still go back to the country, which you have used mouth to control, which you hate with a passion. Hatred. How can you hate people or party unnecessarily? Something you know that you will later go back to. When you speak, look at the kind of venom that comes out of you. Wickedness, hatred, anger, hostility. But after you see, after using your mouth to destroy, you will still go back to the same thing you have destroyed. What is the need? I don't know. I can continue on and on. As I told you, there are so many things to write. You know, it's just, if I should start pouring the way God is even inspiring it to me now, you need know that this hatred and hostility is enough to write a book with this, you know, a book that is as thick as this. We have to summarize it. Okay, all these things we have to summarize it so that it can enter fitting. But there are so many, or any point you raise on this family liberation is enough for another book. Because God revealed a lot. These are the major problems we are having in our families today. Okay, these are the major problems we are having in our society today. Hatred, hostility, and all these things started in the family. We are going to see that now as we reflect, as we go on. Look at that picture. Open your book, day 11. Look at the first picture you see, where a brother killed his own brother. We are talking of family. Where Cain killed Abel. Hatred, the origin of hatred, hostility, family. Why did Abel kill his brother? Can you tell me why Abel should kill his own blood brother? Eh? Same blood brother. Why? We shall see. Please, somebody should call. Let's take it immediately. Hello.
Good evening, Father.
Good evening, my dear. How are you, John? Father. Good evening. How are you?
I'm fine, Father.
Which country are you calling from, please?
I'm calling from United States.
United States of America. Or United States of Amiibo. Which one? But you know, there is something we call United States of Amiibo. Eh? The all USA. United States of Amiibo. So you are not aware. So you better, each time you say US, US, you tell us the which of the US. Whether United States of Abba. Okay. Now you are taking the first paragraph under the picture. Go ahead.
Yes. Cain rose up against Abel, his brother, and killed him.
Hell,
then God said to Cain, "Where is Abel, your brother?" He said, "I do not know. Am I my brother's keeper?" Genesis 4:8-9. This is the origin of family aggression, hatred, and austerity. Every spirit of hatred and austerity is canceled in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. My brother, my sister, why did Cain kill Abel?
I think he killed Abel because of wanting his hatred, envy and hatred, and jealous. Because I think that if Cain really loved Abel, he won't be jealous or envious of Abel. So I think that one of the reasons why he killed Abel is a hidden hatred, maybe because of one thing or the other.
You see? And what's the name of your family again?
Abanejo's family. Francis Abanejo's family.
Francis.
I want this
family. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. May God deliver your family from that spirit of hatred and hostility in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you, Father.
God bless you. Hello. Hello. How are you? I wish you the same. We are calling from where?
All right.
You are reading from where?
We are calling from London.
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 And this is the family of?
Honor's family.
Eh?
Honor's family.
Honor means mouth. Honor means yes, mouth.
Yes.
The family of mouth. Okay. So why there?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, use that mouth. Oh yeah, use that. Honor na megine. Honor did what? Okay, honor the kurora, the mouth that speak for the public. Okay, use that mouth and proclaim to
like me.
Okay, just like who? Okay, me, I'm on the ground. I didn't know. So that's what you people call me, on the ground. Don't worry, I will reduce my volume now. Onu ne kuroa. Is that what you people mean? So that's how you are beginning to see me. Onu ne kuroa one. Okay, now use that same onu. Use that your mouth. Read the next paragraph. Onu. Now you are talking to the whole world on this platform. Go ahead. The next paragraph. June. Amen.
Jesus is the international day of innocent children, victims of aggression. Commenting on this essay, this celebration, Teresa Hedgeford, the executive director of UNICEF, declared, children need peace and protection at all times. The rules of war prohibit the unlawful targeting of civilians, attacks on schools or hospitals, the use of recruitment and unlawful detention of children, and the denial of humanitarian assistance. When conflict breaks out, the rules need to be respected, and those who break them need to be held accountable. Enough is enough. Stop attacks on children. War affects everybody, both adults and children. Prevention, however, is better than cure. To stop this, you don't even need war. Hatred, violence, and aggression are the major cause of war.
Is it true? Is it true?
Father.
That hatred can lead to war. Prevention is better than cure. Hatred leads to war. Aggression, violence. Is it not better we avoid all these things that can trigger war? You will not know the importance of peace until you lose it. May God deliver your family from that spirit of hatred. May God deliver your family from aggression. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you very much. God bless you all. Family of honor, God bless you. I love you. Okay, God bless you. Good night, dear sweetheart. God bless you. Hello.
Hello,
how are you, dear?
I'm fine, Father. Are you?
I'm cool. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Uyo, Nigeria.
Uyo, Nigeria. And what's the name of this family?
This is Ezenwa family, Tobetuko Ezenwa family.
Ezenwa, go ahead. The next paragraph.
The next paragraph.
War and other forms of violence.
And I see.
Go back after the first paragraph. After the very first paragraph, then we have war and other forms of violence.
Okay. Okay. War and other forms of violence have negative impacts, not only in the family or society, but also in the lives of the children. When two elephants fight, it's always the grass that suffers. Almost all the aggressive behaviors you find in the society today started in and within the family. That is why the book of Proverbs 22, chapter 22, verse 6, insists, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it.
Is it not true?
Very true, Father. Very, very true.
And that's why I said, don't expose your children to violence, to war. All these things, they are movie that has to do. Stop your children from worship, watching or seeing aggressive movie. is what to give these children that they will play out in future.
Yeah.
If you keep exposing them to violent movie, wrestling, horror film, war film, those children are going to grow up to become violent in the society. Thank you very much, my dear. God bless you.
Thank you, Father.
Please try to call the WhatsApp. Save your distance. Okay? Thank you very much.
Father.
Okay, please call the WhatsApp if possible, as much as possible. It's on. Okay? So that if need be, I can even visit your family by entering the video call. Hello. Which country is this?
It's Canada.
Canada. Okay.
Yes, Father.
What's the name of the family again?
The name of the family is Uchuchenan Dulaka's family.
Okay, read the next paragraph, please.
My daughter will read when you read.
Okay.
Because aggression has gradually become a tradition. People now see it as a way of life. In the name of discipline, most parents have become so cruel to their children. They shout at them, they beat them up, and even place all kinds of curses on them. At a very tender age, children are exposed to violent movies such as wrestling, war movies, horror movies. Through these movies, children are
initiated
into the spirit of violence and aggression. Consequently, in a family, you will find brothers fighting against their own brothers and sisters fighting against their sisters for no reason. Some